co-college Cohawks and the home team, Dolores College Duhawks. I'm Adam Rodriguez. Joined beside me is my good friend Ryan Haver. Ryan, how are we doing?
We're doing great, Adam. This should be, like you said, a great game. Dolores, 3-8 record right now. They're on a 7-game losing streak. They're hoping to change that, get some momentum in the win columns today.
Absolutely. Let's take a quick look at tonight's starting lineups for the Co-College Cohawks. We have number 2, Maddie Parsons, number 4, Ella Kolak, number 13, Kate Tidman, number 12, Rachel Kilpatrick, number 16, Maddie Moss. And for the Dolores College Duhawks, on that side, their starting line and starting to serve for us will be number 31, Sarah Hoskins, number 9, James Keefe, number 16, Sam Stoffergen, number 5, Kat Gleason, number 8, Alexis Woltman, and number 25, Abby Kwiatkowski. Hoskins serves for the Duhawks to start the game off. And the first attempt by the Cohawks is just long. Furlong went for that attempt there. Hoskins to serve. They set up Parsons. And then that violation by the Duhawks will be point for the Cohawks. Ryan, early stages of the game, who are your players to look out for the Cohawks tonight?
Right now for the Cohawks, I'm looking at Maddie Parsons. And looking down this line, I think another one to keep an eye on is Kate Tidman, senior. Both excellent players for Co. See what they do tonight.
Absolutely. As you said, Parsons coming into tonight with 95 kills and Tidman with 137. Two players from last year as well, both outstanding players on last year's team. Point there for the Duhawks.
Co coming in with a 9-3 record. They're on a 2-game win streak, 1-0 in conference play. But interesting stat in playing away, 0-1. So let's see how they fare here.
Set up Tidman just gets it over. Poor communication there from the Duhawks. Cohawks up 3-2 here in the early stages of this first set. Gleason receives a serve. Hoskins sets up Keefe. Keefe's attempt blocked at the net. Oh, near whiff out of Grace Lucan there, the junior middle. That'll put Gleason back to serve for the Duhawks. Now we talked about Co-College's key players for tonight. Ryan, who are you looking at on the Duhawks side?
The Duhawks side, I'm looking at Kat Gleason, and I'm also looking at Olivia Smith as potential breakout players for the game. And it looks like a timeout, maybe?
Not entirely sure. What's going on? The ref went and talked to both coaches. Not entirely sure. Both teams are just huddling up on their own. Like you said, you mentioned earlier, Duhawks obviously 3-8, not the greatest record that they want, obviously. They're a young team. Looking at their roster, they've got a lot of freshmen and sophomores accumulating on this team. And it hurts last year graduating 4 very solid players, one being Lindsay Wilgenbush, another Crystal Tranel. Wilgenbush led the team last year in kills, and she's definitely been a factor that they're missing right now. She had 455. You can definitely see that's hurting the Duhawks at sometimes. Her presence there was well known by the other teams. And then throw Liz Fleckenstein in there on the other side with her, and they were a hard duo.
Absolutely. And I look at this team, and I look at youth. And you mentioned a lot of freshmen. This is going to be a season of development. You may not see the Loras College DuHawks competing for a title in the division this season, but look, definitely in coming seasons, they should be a powerhouse for the ARC.
Absolutely. So I believe it's just to get this little stoppage here, just put some tape down onto the court for the up and down refs to see the line splitting up the front and back to help with those back row attacks. And now we will resume play with Kat Gleason back to serve. As we are tied 3-3 here in this first set. First serve over, Parsons receives it. Set up Tinman. Deep attempt, tip, and in. Poor communication from the Quahawks.
Excuse me, it didn't look like Stroffergen got the ball completely. A little off the fingertips.
Mm-hmm. Hawson's there for the dig. Gleason getting up for Woltman. Woltman, a little tip over. Set up Parsons from the back. Just long. Gleason still back to serve. Good point, Quahawks there. Maddie Harris comes in and goes back to serve for the Quahawks. Keith receives it. Hoskins sets up Woltman, and hers is just long and out of bounds. Deer receives the serve. Hoskins setting up Smith.
Nice block.
Good attempt there from Keith. Tidman. Stockton's there. Good kill there from Lucan. Her serve, good dig.
Nice save by the DuHawks.
Good save. Tidman, huge kill there from Tidman over on left side. Quahawks now up 7-5. Still in the earlier stages of this first set. Moss to Harrison in the back. A dig there from Deer. Hoskins sits up Smith. She just tips it. Oh, DuHawks on a little roll here. Oh, just a bad air there on the reception, and the Quahawks will call the first timeout of this match. Not the Quahawks team probably this DuHawks team was expecting. The Quahawks usually a lot more, what's the word here? They're usually in it better. Communication's off right now.
Oh, yeah.
You can tell. That's not a typical thing from them. Last year, these two teams met, and Co won this season series 2-0. The first game being the regular season, and their second time matchup was in the ARC tournament. That first game did go to 5 sets last year. Co did pull it out 3-2, and then that second meeting, Co would go on to sweep the DuHawks 3-0. So obviously DuHawks looking to get the win over the Quahawks tonight for their first and who knows, could possibly be the only matchup against the Quahawks this year.
Yeah, like we said earlier, it's going to be big, big development year for a lot of these freshmen. And play resumes. Nice block by number 31, Sarah Hoskins.
tipping it back to serve for the Cohawks.
The crowd is into it for sure.
The
early
serve is long. Yeah, absolutely.
James keeps serving for the Duhawks, and it's over the net. Oh, and good save.
Timman over to Parsons. Attempt keeps there. Hoskins sets up Koski. Good block from the Cohawks. That's over there for the Cohawks. Point will go to the Cohawks.
Good idea, but just a little off on that. Grace with the serve. Nick missing the serving now for Loras College. Number 16, Sam Strofford again.
Good dig. And Koski's attempt, very long. Moss will now go back to serve. Good tip, rebound. Over and into the crowd. We talked about the Duhawks losing some key players last year. Cohawks as well lost a couple key players there. Teeple led the team with assists with 1,213. But their Fatty Moss, we've said her name quite a bit tonight, obviously. She definitely taking the role very seriously, and they didn't lose Teeple at all.
Yeah, that last play, good communication by the Duhawks, just falling off a little bit at the end of the play. Fatty Moss serve.
Hoskins to Key from the back row, and her attempt goes into the net. Cohawks now taking a 13-12 lead over the Duhawks. Moss still back to serve. Keep receives. Hoskins sets up Koski. Good kill there from the Duhawks. Beautiful set from Hoskins. Over to Abby. Duhawks make a quick substitution. They're going to bring Waltman back into the game for McAtee. Austin serve received by Parsons. And that attempt from Furlong by the Duhawks. Pass. Parsons just got to get a free ball over the Duhawks. Stoffergen, Hoskins, Waltman. Line drive. Okay, there's going to be a point for the Duhawks. Moss goes to Tim. Back and dig.
It looks like
we're going to say under the net violation from the Duhawks. They'll go point for Co.
Maddie Parson with the serve, and it's over. Point to the Cohawks. Good defense on that play.
Parson to serve. Stoffergen, good to see there. Almost a little miscommunication there from the Duhawks. Oh. Please.
We got a substitution.
Here coming in for Abby. Her serve clips the net. Parson receives it. Moss, she just got a free ball and finds a spot.
Good effort, and that's what we want to see from this young team. Effort and just learning the game, learning their teammates. Obviously, they've probably been playing for a few years, but you want to see kind of that.
Unfortunate error there from Deer on that reception of the serve. The Quahawks just get a kill right at the net.
Ella Kolak with the serve. Deer with the save.
Oldman, good attempt. They set up Furlong. Tipped and out of bounds.
Looks like Duhawks are going to take a timeout. Regroup here.
Good call there. Good call.
Heading into the timeout. The Quahawks 18, Duhawks 16.
Duhawks coming into tonight's game after a loss to Gustavus Adolphus College this past Saturday. They lost 3-0. Hard-fought game for the Duhawks, but, you know, it's definitely tough when you're going up against the number 8 team in the nation in Gustavus with such a young team like we have here at Loras. As for Coe, they are coming into tonight's game after a 3-2 win over Concordia University, so they're definitely riding some momentum into tonight's game. We'll see if they can keep it and take the W over Loras tonight.
And we're back into the action. Oh, looks like Riley Deer barely got it, and the Quahawks end up with the point. 19-16, Quahawk lead.
Gleason's attempt blocked at the net. Furlong pushed over. Hoskins has to get it over, and her attempt just off to the left. Quahawks now take a 20-16 lead in this first set. And Quahawks still back to serve.
And save. Oh. And they're going to get it over the net.
Free ball. Hoskins. Gleason. Gets the kill there.
Let's see if the Duhawks can ride this momentum. 20-7. And Kat Gleason will serve it over to the Quahawks.
Moss, it's a Furlong. Whew. Big time kill over on the outside for Maggie Furlong, the freshman.
Looks like we got a substitution. For Co, number 7 Furlong going out and coming in and serving Maddie Harris, number 30. She gets it over.
Timna's attempt blocked at the net by Livian Woltman. Good dig there from Hoskins. Stoffergen's got to get to Keefe. Keefe gets it over. Hoskins, Smith, and Smith's just long.
Right idea. Off target on that one. Nice. And out again for the Duhawks. And the Quahawks, 23-17, lead in this first set.
They have Maddie Harris back to serve for them. Quick substitution for the Duhawks. Amelia Gutierrez comes in for Olivia Smith. Tyler Moore on this DuHawks team. Hoskins to Keefe. Good tip there from the Cohawks. They can get it going. Oh,
nice move.
Nice move just out. Good look there from Moss. Just a bit outside. McAtee comes back in and will go back to serve. Tidman. Her attempt goes into the net. It'll be a point for the DuHawks. DuHawks making a little run here. Down 23-19. And just like that, it's over. McAtee's service ace now puts the Cohawks 1 point away from set victory.
And serving the ball over for the Cohawks is Kate Tidman, number 13.
Osmond's got to get over scoreboard. Deer free ball. Moss sets up Parson. Parson. Hoss. Here it is.
In.
She finds a spot in the back. Got to highlight that possession. Great hustle there from Hoskins. Ended up running into the scores table. Make sure that ball stays alive for the DuHawks. Keith serves. Tidman receives. Moss is at Parson. Hoskins to Gutierrez.
Oh.
Whoa, big kill there from Grace Lucan. After that kill, the Cohawks take a 25-20 first set win. We'll go up 1-0 here over the DuHawks. Ryan, after that first set, what are you liking so far out of both teams? What's standing out for you?
Well, I'm liking the effort and the plays. As we saw that one play for the Cohawks for number 16, Maddie Maz, when she was trying to serve it over, very creative, crafty. That's what you want to see. And the DuHawks are doing a little bit for themselves a few points ago, saving the ball from the scorer's table.
Absolutely.
A little bit of a feeling out match early on, but Cohawks going on a bit of a run. And they've got a 1-set lead.
Absolutely. After that first set, let's take a quick look at tonight's stat leaders for Coe College. They've got three girls tied with 4 kills. Maggie Furlong, Kate Tidman, and Grace Lucan. And for the DuHawks, Olivia team in kills after that first set with 2. Gleason at 1 and Woltman at 1. Look at team stats. Loris and Coe tied with 10 attackers. Coe having 40 total attacks and Loris with 36. 2 service errors for Coe and 1 for the DuHawks. Pretty tight contest so far. Only a 5-point difference in the first set. So we should be in for a very, very close rest of this match. Hopefully DuHawks can come out in the second one and even this entire match tonight. Coming into tonight's game, let's talk about some overall statistics for the conference. Coe was coming into tonight with the third highest hitting percentage at 19.8%. Loris coming in at 7 with 13.3. Coe also third in the conference coming into tonight, averaging about 11.7 kills per match. Or per set, excuse me. Pretty impressive numbers there out of the Cohawks. For Loris, they're sitting at 6, averaging about 10.5 kills a set. Coast in the conference with 10.8 assists per set as well, and Loris with 9.5 assists per set. We look at stats. Sarah Hossetter, leading the team in assists this year. And last year, she's coming into tonight, she was at 215, and last year she led the team. So the team with 1,176, so impressive numbers from Hoss. Hopefully you'll see her for the entirety of tonight.
And looking individually at the ARC records this year for Code, Gracie Urbach, we have still yet to see her on the court tonight, but she is eighth in the conference with a .240 hitting percentage. And Grace Lucan, who we have seen tonight, 11th in the conference with a .235 hitting percentage. Just want to highlight those two players for the Cohawks.
Absolutely.
And it looks like for the Cohawks, Maddie Maz is going to serve it over.
Keith receives it. Hoskins has to go over to it.
Good hit, but just out.
Holtman's attack goes out into the right. Austin sets up Gleason, and her attempt tipped by the Cohawks. Will be a point for Loris. Deer comes back in for Kukoski. And she will go back to serve. Parsons, Maddie. Set up her line and just a big air from the Cohawks.
And we did this before the set. Crafty plays. It's little things like that. Little tip can confuse the other team. As you see Riley Deer serving the ball over to the Cohawks.
Maz Parson. Parson's attempt blocked at the net. Hoskins sets it up. Woltman little tip. Great hustle there from Furlong. Gotta go Tidman. Free ball from the back. Deer, Hoskins, Gleason.
Good save for the Dewhawks. Cohawks showing some urgency themselves.
Got a good volley going here. Keeps attempt dug there. Parsons, good dig there from Sofagin. Keith goes. Cohawks there. Parsons. And finally, Cohawks get the point from the kill from Parsons.
Serving it over for the Cohawks. Number two, Maddie Parson. A little low to the ground.
Ace there from Parson. One of the first ones we've seen tonight. Actually, the first ace of tonight. Parson, Maz, Tidman. Good block there from the Dewhawks. Furlong goes. Good dig from Hoskins. Woltman, free ball.
Looks like it was mishit.
A little miscommunication as well on that Dewhawks side. Cohawks up 4-2 here in the second set.
We got a substitution for the Dewhawks. Alexis Woltman goes to the bench. It looks like Allie Burke comes in.
Reception error there from Deer. Almost a costly error. Maz Tidman. Tidman tip. Blocked at the net, but Burke couldn't get it back up. Poor possibility of getting the point. Parsons still back to serve for Coe.
Yeah, I'm noticing Coe getting on these longer runs of about 5 or 6 points. Dewhawks got to find an end to it,
well,
and there's the end.
From Gleason. After that kill, Gleason will go back to serve for the Dewhawks. See from Tidman, Moss.
Nice misdirection from the Quahogs. And it looks like for the Quahogs, number 12, Rachel Kilpatrick, will sub out. And subbing in her place looks like number 18, Grace Lucan. As we move on to this next match.
Oh, good dig there from Quahog. Tidman. Whew. Big time kill there from Kate Tidman.
Laser beam. No one blocking that one. Can the Quahogs?
Good hustle there from Parson. There's going to be a free ball from the Quahogs. Stoffergen, Hoskins, Keefe. Good dig there from Parson.
Whew.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Wow. Big time kill.
What a
kill.
Snipe.
Big time kill there from the middle, Grace Lucan.
Yeah, good timeout. 8-3. Quahog lead right now.
Lucan on the season last year was at finished 276 kills on her in her sophomore year. Tidman, we've said her name quite a bit tonight, leading the team in kills last year with 414. So obviously, she's definitely made her presence felt for Loras. Big factor on this team, along with Parson, who finished with 353 kills. And we've seen her serve quite a bit tonight. One ace already for her. She finished with 67 service aces last year. Titten, Parson, Lucan. Three huge key factors for this very, very solid Co-College Quahogs team.
Yeah, Co so far in this game, 20 kills to Loras, 9 kills. As we get back to the game, Quahogs serving over to the Duhawks.
Sets up Keefe.
Nice stop by Quahogs. Unfortunately, it does not go the Quahogs' way, but fortunately for the Duhawks, that means 8-4.
Good block there. We talked about hitting percent tonight. Co sitting at a 14.8%, while the Duhawks sitting at a... Ooh, wow. Big kill there from Tidman.
Fast hands, fast points.
Like I was saying, Duhawks sitting at a negative 0.043 hitting percentage tonight. Probably not the number you want to see for that Duhawks team.
O'Reilly Deer struggled with getting the ball and a little layup move from Tidman. James Keefe.
Good dig there from Deer. Hoskins going to set up Keefe. Going to hit the antenna, and it will be a point for the Quahogs.
And before that point, Furlong going out, Harris coming in. Harris doing a great job serving the ball over tonight. No errors thus far. And it looks like the ball goes around the antenna. Hawk point, 11-4 lead in favor of the Quahogs.
Sub for the Duhawks. James Keith will check out, and coming into the game will be freshman Sophie Yunkin. Again, another freshman on this Duhawk team. Reception error, almost costly for the Duhawks. Tidman. She gets over. There's Big Moss. Tidman's just got to bump it over. Hoskins. So nice little dump over.
Smart
from
play.
Beautiful dump over. Come back in for Riley Deer. And Yunkin goes back to serve for Loras. Attack error from Parson. Be a point for the Duhawks. Quahog receives a serve. Moss sets up Tidman. Tip there. Good dig attempt there from Kutkowski.
Duhawks need to start moving their feet over towards the ball. Just waiting and hitting it last minute. Let's see if they can change that now.
Kidman served. Junkin receives it. Back row attack.
Barely out.
Side. Tidman to serve. Hoskins. Oh. Good kill there from Abby. Beautiful set from Hoskins as well.
Yeah, not much the Quahawks could do on that one.
Stofferton serves. Tidman receives it. Moss sets up Parson. Good dig there from Stofferton. Hoskins met at the net. It's going to be a lift, and it'll be a point for the Quahawks. Lucan to serve. Good attempt there from Abby. Stofferton, Hoskins, Kukowski. Good kill there. Block attempt goes out of bounds. It'll be a point for the Duhawks.
Yeah, Cohen Morris tied with 24 digs right now. Great save by Kalak to keep this point going.
Good dump over from Moss. Hoskins sets up Abby. Oh, they keep it alive. Burke there to just put it down in the open spot. Quahawks not ready for it.
Little dunkaroo over there. 14-9.
Good serve there from Hoskins. Moss sets up Parson. Parson has to adjust. Pollock, back row attack from Tidman. Hoskins to Burke. Burke gets it over. Oh, Kilpatrick. A little nice tip there from the middle. Furlong comes back in for Maddie Harris. And Maddie Moss will go back to serve for the Quahawks. Hoskins sets up Burke. Attack error there from Burke.
Looks like she was hitting the ball on a downward angle. If it was just a little bit earlier, just time it right, for sure going right over the net. A little confusion on what to do there for Burke. Burke gets it over to Kolak, keeping possession.
Gleason's attack blocked. There's free ball from the Duhawks. Moss is a Furlong.
Great sequence for the Duhawks. There.
Big time block there for the Duhawks.
Riley Deer coming in for Kwiatkowski. Good communication for the Duhawks.
First attempt blocked by Furlong Kilpatrick.
Maddie Parson back with the serve. Just short.
Serve. Air.
Gifting the Duhawks a point to add to their in this match. 17-11. They still trail by six. Gleason serving it over. This time it goes over.
Phillip Tittman on the outside. Hoskins. Gleason. Burke. Tipped by the Quahawks. Oh, good tip there from Kilpatrick. Just finding the spot. Duhawks unable to get there. Lucan comes back in for Kilpatrick, and Kolak is back to serve.
Good save by the Duhawks. Goes out of bounds. Quahawk point.
Good Good ace there from Elkolak. Hoskins sets up Burke.
Woo! What a missile by Burke. And Burke's going to be subbed out for Talia McAtee, who will come in and serve over to the Quahawks.
Kidman receives it. Maz going to set up Lucan. Whew. Oh, big time kill there from Lucan. Quahawks up 20-12 in this second set. And that will put Harris back to serve. Stoppington receives it. Hoskins has to get it out for Yunkin.
Just out.
And that attack error will just be out to the left. Harris to serve. Good tip there from Smith. Hawks down 21-13. Krakowski's coming back in for Deer, and Keith will go back to serve.
Duhawk's doing a great job of finding the open spaces. Oh, nice. Counts nice 1-2 punch for the Duhawks.
Moss will dump over Hoskins. She went for the attack there. Tidman. Hoskins there for the dig. Hoskins. Unfortunate set there from Hoskins. A little long for Abby.
Leads into a Duhawk timeout.
Quahawks up 22-13 here in this second set. Not as close to the set as the first one. Quahawks have gotten a lot of things rolling in this second set. Wouldn't be surprised if they keep it going for the rest of the game.
We're seeing great effort by the Duhawks, though. That last play, that 1-2 on the court. Not able to finish for the point, but as we take a look, 25 kills for Ko, 15 kills for Loris so far. And the hit percentage for Loris coming up a little bit, still in the negatives at negative 0.028. And hit percentage for Ko, 0.149.
Maggie Furlong and Kate Tidman both with 7 kills for the Quahawks. Lucan right behind them with 5. Olivia Smith, Kat Gleason, and Abby Krakowski all with 3 kills. Tidman serve received from McAtee. Good dig there from Pollock. She sets up Harris from the back.
Nice save for the Quahawks.
Stockton, Hoskins, Smith, Tipple. Good hustle there. Oh my gosh. I think the Quahawks have found that one spot on the Duhawks side. Maybe more than 5 times already tonight. They're just finding a weakness in that Duhawk defense right now.
They'll give the point over to the Duhawks.
Service area there from Tidman. Duhawks down 23-14. Stoffergen to serve. Moss sets up Parson. Good digger from McAtee. Hoskins sets up Key from the back.
Duhawks keeping play alive.
Free ball. She tries to find the spot. Good hustle there from Parson. Tidman. Attack. Oh, big kill there from Gleason.
Gleason with her 4th kill of the night. A lot of open room back there on that last point.
Harris from the back. Good dig there from Keith. attack error there from Abby. And the Quahawks will now send Lucan back to serve for set point. Stockerton, Hoskins, Kowski. Good dig there from Tidman. Moss sets up Parson. Oh! Good kill there from Parson, and the Quahawks will take a 25-15 second set victory and will go up 2-0 over the Duhawks. We've got about 2:45 left in between the sets, and we will come back with the third set action between the visiting Coe College Quahawks and the Loras College Duhawks. Welcome back to Lillis Court in the AWC here at Loras College in Dubuque, Iowa. Once again, I'm Adam Rodriguez, and joined by me is Ryan Haywood. We are entering the third set of tonight's matchup between the visiting Coe College Quahawks and the home team, the Loras College Duhawks. Coe took a first set win with a score of 25-20 and came out and won the second set 25-15. Kilpatrick leading the Quahawks now with 8 kills. Tidman with 7 and Furlong at 5. Gleason at 4 for the Duhawks. Smith and Kwiatkowski both with 3. Both teams are back on the court, and I believe it will be Coe who will serve first.
Getting some final roster adjustments on the court. And it looks like for the Duhawks, it's going to be Sarah Hoskins serving over in this third set. And we are underway at Lillis Court with the third match.
Oh, good save there from Moss. Just a couple errors there on the Duhawks side, and it'll be an early point for the Quahawks. And we'll send Parson back to serve. Parson serve. And such an error there from Stoffergen. It'll be another ace for Parson.
I thought that was out, but it looks like the refs had a better shot than I did. Quahawks with an early 3-0 lead in this third set. Maddie Parsons, excellent all night serving over.
Hoskins sets up Keith, Parson, Moss, Furlong. Good tip there from Duhawks. Keith from the back. Good pick up from Moss. Kolog. Tidman with a free ball. Good kill there from Gleason. Getting their first point of this third set here.
It looks like Riley Deer coming in for Abby.
Moss sets up Tidman. Good touch from the Duhawks. And Moss just has to get it over Deer. Hoskins, Gleason tip. Furlong's there. Oh, good dig there from Stockerton.
Nice save by Deer.
Great rally we've got going on here. Kilpatrick right to Hoskins. Stockerton, Keefe, Van just long. Clock back to serve. Deer receives it. Hoskins. Supposed to go to Gleason, and it'll be an error. Attack error for the Duhawks, and the Quahawks now go up 5-1. Ooh, good kill there from Maggie Furlong. That's now her sixth. Hoskins to Keith. Woo! Good kill there from Keith. Gutierrez coming back in for Sofergen and Gleason. Now back to serve. Oh, wow. Wow. Good attack there from the Quahawks. Tidman. Graham gets it over. Deer. Good dig. Hoskins. Smith. Good dig. Parsons has to just get it over.
Good save by the Quahawks.
Tidman. Good touch on the Duhawks. Just Keith just couldn't get there in time. Harris back in. Will go back to serve. And Stoffergen will come back in as well. Keith, Deer. Keith's attack. Miscommunication there from Parson and Cola. There's a point there for the Duhawks. McAtee comes back in and we'll go back to serve. Tidman. Oh, that's good. Very good kill there from Tidman. Good touch from the Duhawks. It just happened to land on their side. And Tidman will go back to serve. Keep it up from the Quahawks. Net battle. Hoskins, Gutierrez, she gets it over. Oh, great dig there from Deer. Keith. Moss will dump over. Good rally going. Good tip. Tidman from the back. And just a bit outside.
Looks like a hit. Hit weirdly off of Tidman's hand. Definitely not where she wanted it to go, but Duhawks will take that. Only down 4 points, 8-4.
And Keith will just send that just long. And that'll put Luke in back to serve.
In terms of early game, this is a lot closer than the second match.
Parson. Attempt dug by Keith. Hoskins tries to get it over. And Kukowski's attempt is just outside to the right. He'll be out of bounds, and the Quahawks will now go up 6 as they lead 10-4.
Lukanen serves it over. Looks like the Duhawks going to mishandle the play.
An ace there for Lukin after that error from the Duhawks.
Nice block in front. Looks like that was Gutierrez.
Stoffergen serves. Tim receives it. Moss to Parson. Hoskins again in the scores table. Another error there from the Duhawks.
Yeah, Cohawks starting to take a bigger lead.
Yeah, they're looking to put this one away in three. Hoskins over to Abby. Good touch. Moss, Tidman. Attempt. Oh, good dig there from Moss. Cohawks got to get it. Tidman, free ball. Furlong. Furlong with the kill. Cohawks now at 13-5. That is the 31st kill.
Adam, one thing I'm noticing are that the Duhawks, despite their play, they're keeping things, I would say, pretty consistent all night. I mean, nothing too crazy, especially in this third set down 13-5, but you never know. They could go on another run.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think a big thing for the Duhawks right now has just been the errors. Five reception errors to Coe's 0, 20 attack errors to Coe's 16. Obviously, Loris has had 2 service errors while Coe's had 4, but I mean, right there, I mean, that's just been a big factor for the Duhawks tonight. A lot of miscommunication, a lot of errors, and that's just how you could say that's how they've gotten to this point, being down 2 sets. 0 and now down 13-5 in this third set, trying to stay alive and push it to a fourth set and trying not to go home with being swept. Hoskin will go back to serve. Good touch there from the Duhawks. Abby's got to get it over. Pollock. Moss, Parson. Oh, very nice spot. Good kill there from Parson. Going to find the open gap in the Duhawk defense. And Parson will now go back to serve. And he'll drop. Austin Smith, little tip. Moss, Kilpatrick. Furlong, blocks. Oh, big block there from the Duhawks. I believe that was Pat Gleason again.
Cat putting up a wall defensively. Great effort from her tonight. And just like that, the Duhawks are only down 7, 14-7, heading into this match.
So Patrick attacked. Keith. Oh, that's going to be a kill for Keith after a tip. On the Cohawk block attempt. Deer serves. Cohawk receives it. Moss sets up. Furlong throw on tip. It's going to be dumped down onto the Cohawk side by Keith. And the Cohawks now only up 14-9, and they will take a timeout. Nice little run Duhawks are putting on right now. Cohawks up 14-9 in the timeout, looking to put away the Duhawks. You know, good timeout call there for the Cohawks. Duhawks going to run. They're trying to stop that. As the Duhawks, momentum definitely on their side right now, and hopefully they will continue that and pull within maybe one or two and possibly pull out a very good comeback in this third set. Twenty seconds left on this timeout. Duhawks back out on the court. Cohawks coming out of their huddle. The action will happen here very shortly. Deer still back to serve for the Duhawks. Goodman's just got to get it over. Yeah. Stoffergen, Hoskins, so Smith. I think it might have been a little miscommunication between Smith and Hoskins, but Smith was going in just a little too close, and Hoskins just set her up just a little too far behind her head. Hoskins, Keefe, dug by Parsons. Parsons, Tomas, Tidman. Stoffergen over to Keefe. Keefe goes for the attempt. Parsons there. Moss Furlong.
Good dig save there by Deer.
Good attack from Gleason. It'll go to Tidman over on the outside. Hoskins is there. Good dig. Tidman. Oh, Quahog's looking for a tip. Line judge say there was none, and it'll be a point for the Duhawks.
I'm inclined to agree with Coe. And it's going to stay the Duhawks 15-10.
Good dig from Hoskins. Gleason has to give it to Keith. Oh my gosh, another miscommunication there between Parson and Kolak. We've seen that quite a bit between the two of them in that back row.
Yeah, rare butterfinger moment for Maddie Parsons. Just looked like just right out of her hands. But she gets that one.
Good touch there from Duhawks. Hoskins sets up Gutierrez. Attack air, and it'll be a block for the Quahogs.
Looks like she missed the ball completely, just hit the net. And it looks like serving over for Co, number 30, Maddie Harris.
Keith, Hoskins, Gutierrez, another block for the Quahogs, and a block for Lucan. Keith, Hoskins, call it a touch on Hoskins. Another error for the Duhawks, and another point for the Quahogs. As they are now 18-11 in this third set. Harris still to service. Stoffergen, Hoskins, Keith. Good dig there from Parson. Smith just has to get it over.
Good save by Maddie Harris. Keep possession going. And she tries to do it again.
Beautiful kill there from Keith. Good touch from the Quahogs. Parson just wasn't able to get over and get that second hit.
Smith going out for the Duhawks and coming in. Talia McAtee serves it over. Nicely done.
Tidman. And her attempt is just outside and out of bounds.
Looks like a little bit of life for the Duhawks. I don't want to the commentators, but 18-13, things are looking on the upswing for the Duhawks.
Parson from the back, Deer, good dig. Rakeef. Oh, good touch from Parson. Quahogs just got to give a free ball to the Duhawks, and Hoskins will set up Keefe. Good tip. Moss, little dump over. Stoffergen's there. Good touch from Gutierrez.
Good save by Deer.
Wow. Great dig from Deer. Tidman.
Good save by the Duhawks. Mm. They can't make anything out of it. 19-13 Quahog lead. You got to love the hustle for the Duhawks, but to no avail, no point on that one.
Absolutely. The hustle all over the place on both sides. And Tidman with a service error. Quahogs up 19-14. And Keith will go back to serve. Kukowski coming back in for Deer.
Yeah, Deer with that great save for the Duhawks. As we head over.
Oh, yeah.
Barely nice. Anybody in the backcourt.
Nice kill there from Lucan. Checking in for the Dewhawks is freshman number 30, Kylie Garrett. Another error from the Dewhawks on that serve. Co looks up 21-14, and Duncan taking the timeout. Like I said, 21-14, Quahog lead. Definitely looking to put this one away here in the next few points. As for the Dewhawks, they just got to do whatever they can, stay alive, and hope that they can put together a massive, massive comeback against this very solid Quahog's team.
And, you know, just looking at the blocks, it's 3-1 over Co and the Dewhawks with three, that is. And it's really headlined by Kat Gleason. You're putting up that great defensive effort. They just got to put together a couple of rallies, see if they can salvage this match. And attack errors a little high for both sides. Six for Co, five for Loris.
Lucan to serve.
Crowd loving that one.
Hastings, Koski. Good block there from the Quahogs. They now go up 22-14. Lucan to serve. Unfortunately, almost a reception error that costly for the Dewhawks. And Parsons is going to have herself a kill there. 2 points away from the sweep for the Quahogs. I'm sure Lucan's looking to be the... Oh, and her serve goes out to the left.
Yeah, for a moment, I thought Garrett was going to hit it, but good decision by her to leave it. And now serving over for college, for Loris College, that is, Sam Stroffinger.
Good dig there from McAtee. Hoskins sets up Abby. Abby's got a tack.
Good effort by the Dewhawks, but the point will go to Co College, 24-15. They're looking to settle this one right now. Relatively fast game. The serve is over on the Dewhawks side. Returning. Abby serves it over.
Moss, Parson. Good dig there, Hoskins. Over to Abby. Blocked by the Quahogs. And that'll do it for tonight, folks. The Quahogs take a 3-set-2-none match victory over the Dewhawks, winning that one 25-15. All around, great. Great game, great showing out of the Quahogs. Unfortunate. Unfortunate showing out of the Dewhawks. Like I said, a lot of errors out of them. Hopefully they can bounce back. They will travel to, actually, they will. Dewhawks will stay here at home for a little tournament. They play on Saturday at 12 versus University of Wisconsin La Crosse at 12. And then they will follow that on Saturday as well and play Edgewood. As for the Quahogs, they will travel to Waverly for the Wartburg invite and then play the University of Wisconsin Stout. As for tonight, thank you for tuning in again. I'm Adam Rodriguez. This is Ryan Haywood. We hope to see you guys next time. Have a good one.
Thank you.